Hello from Germany, this is Linz Delta Lima 8, Romeo Delta Lima, and in this hopefully short video, I would like to introduce to you how you can set up SDR console in connection, in CAT connection to a Logger32. So, first of all, you need a serial port for that, a virtual serial port, because SDR console is a software piece and a Logger32 on this left side is of course also a piece of beautiful, wonderful software. So first of all, you need a program which is called Virtual Serial Port Manager. Virtual Serial Port Manager. And you can find this on this webpage of k5fr.com. K5fr.com. Stephen Nance is his name of this kind amateur radio operator, because he offers us, the community, for free this Virtual Serial Port Manager by K5FR. So you have to install this, and the only thing you have to do is, so there is no way to really download it for anywhere free in the net. So you have to drop him a line here, and you have to state that you're a radio amateur. As you can read, if you're not licensed, there are no exceptions. You don't get it then. So you have to be a radio amateur, and within a few hours, you will get a link to download the program. And that's the screen of the program. And with that program, you can set up virtual ports. So that's a screenshot on his webpage. So anyhow, I have set up those serial ports, of course they are serious, serial ports on my machine, as you can see here in my manager. So I have set up COM15 linked to COM16, so that's the begin of the cable, and that's the end of the cable, the other end, and the other way around. So this means there is data flow possible between 15 to 16 and the opposite way. So we have these two ports working. So again, 15 means the beginning of the cable. So one, the right hand of the cable, let's say, and COM16 is the left hand of the cable. So What do we have to do? So we have SDR console to the right, we have a logger to the left. So first we concentrate on SDR console. What do we have to do there? So we have this program options button in the most upper right corner here, a very small button, as you know it probably from other software as well. So you have to click on that. And then you can have a look into controllers, CAT controlling, and port selection. There you see all the ports you have on your machine. So there are several more, but we use COM15. COM15 is ticked here, and that's all for now. You have to read that the protocol should be a Kenwood protocol, Kenwood TS2000. So keep that in mind. So we need this information on the left side when we come back to Logger32. So now we have every information. There they write as well that you can get the VSP manager from K5FR. So Kenwood Tango Sierra 2000, COM15. So we have this. So I assume that you have set up your SDR console properly, that in my case it's a SDR, it's a Lime SDR Mini, and I've set it up that I can enter the reception frequency, which is now set to 10.489860 gigahertz. So it's the same frequency set up here, just to clarify that I'm on this frequency. Of course, we transmit on 30 centimeters, but anyhow, that's not the point in this video. So we have set up everything fine, and we have opened up the COM port. Now we swap over to Logger32 here on this side. Okay, so we see the frequency already here because I've set up the radio already. So I do this again for you. So we go, or we come to setups, as you can see, just okay, you don't see it there. So I have chosen radio 2 for that, and we come to setup in the menu, and once we are in the setup menu from of Logger32, we select radio, and then we select radio 2 configuration, as radio 2 is used for SDR console. I've preset this, of course, before. So the radio 2 configuration is like this. We have selected the other end of the cable. So you remember COM 15 is the right hand of the cable, so in the SDR console, and COM 16 is on the left hand here on our side on Logger. So the baud rate is 57,600, 5K6, and it's 8N1 are the parameters. And in case you don't have a Kenwood Tango Sierra 2000 in your selection menu, which is the case in Logger32, so I've selected the Tango Sierra 900 and 990. So that's it for now. So you can select everything like this. So you need you don't need those boxes checked. Okay, so the only thing, show VFO split offset in radio control panel split label. And here you can, of course, name your radio, and the radio I have called SDR console. If you have set up it like this, you hit apply, you click apply, and so I do cancel because I have already set up this. And then you get this frequency here. So we see a 10.489860. So if you follow my mouse pointer, so I come back to the right side to SDR console. I turn the frequency a little upwards. So the frequency increases, it's 861. And if you look to the Logger window on the most upper left-hand side, the frequency increases as well. So everything works 100%. But there is one thing left, because we don't transmit on 3 centimeters. We don't transmit on 10 gigahertz decimal 489 and so on. We transmit on 13 centimeters. How can we manage it that Logger shows us the correct frequency, as we can see it here in the radio panel or here in the entry pane? So that's not correct. If you lock this QSO, it's wrong, because this frequency will be locked as TX frequency, as the frequency you transmit with. So we have to change this. How can we do that? Logger has the opportunity to switch that over to the right band, and therefore you have to bring up the radio control panel. If you don't know how to do this, I show it So I remove the control panel for you. And so we leave the setup menu here again. So that's the classical Logger32 menu. And then you get up to the view entry here in the menu. Click that. And then you say your Logger32. Show me, please, the radio control panel. So you click it once, and voila, the radio control panel pops up for you. Then you have to select or bring your mouse pointer to that bar here on the side. And there you do a right click. A right click, and then this menu opens up. You drop your mouse pointer down to the bottom where you can read logging frequency setup. So you click it once and this window shows up. Setup split frequency logging options. And there, Bob has entered a very handy feature which says SDR console 3 centimeters 13 centimeters crossband. Automatically calculate frequency from frequency RX. So that means if you click this, Logger does the following. Logger gets the frequency from SDR console. We remember we have 10.489 and so on megahertz. And the correct offset is saved here in the background. So if you click this, Logger subtracts the offset, the correct offset from the RX frequency coming from the SDR console. And a second option, you have to click here, log frequency RX different when you split, when you have split frequencies, which is the case because we are transmitting on 2.4 gigahertz and we are receiving at 10.489 gigahertz. So now we hit apply, and when I do this, watch this line here up there, the frequency line in your entry pane. So it says the 10 gigahertz frequency and 3 centimeters. And now watch it. I click apply now. Here we go. And it doesn't change, unfortunately, because I fear I have... okay, here we got it. So I changed the frequency for a short time, and now we have it. 2.4 gigahertz and 13 centimeters. Everything is fine now, and your band map shows as well 13 centimeters. And the spots coming in, if there are spots coming in for here, for example, here, 2.418, so we got this spot. You don't see it there because screen is off there. Anyhow, so this leads you to that situation that when you lock a QSO, you have the TX frequency, as you can see here in this area, is locked with a 2.4 gigahertz, and the RX frequency is 10.489 and so on gigahertz as well. So I hope this helped you a little to configure your station with the correct CAT connection between SDR console and Logger32. If there are more further questions, drop me a line to my email address, deltalima8romeodeltalima@darc.de. Thanks for watching and have fun on the satellite or wherever on the radio. Bye-bye.